Next, for the opening statement, we have invited a top-notch geopolitics analyst, nationalist intellectual, book author, social media celebrity, also host of the Statecraft TV show with SMNI News, Ms. Sasot Rogando. Sasot has been educated in Europe, of course in the Philippines also. She has master's degree in international relations from Leiden University. She earned her BA combined major in world politics and global justice, minor in international development, magna cum laude honors from Leiden University. She also studied her BA in business administration in human resource management from the Open University of Hong Kong, plus etc. She has a very long bio data, but I just summarized just some of the highlights. Let us welcome the highly respected and fearless Ms. Sas Rogando Sasot.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. I am speaking today as a citizen of the Philippines. I am speaking today as a Filipino whose identity is rooted in centuries of subjugation from the Kingdom of Spain, the United States of America, and Japan. An identity that flourished through the freedom fought by our ancestors against these colonizers. I am speaking today as an Asian, fully embracing our amazing pre-colonial history and the contribution of our diverse cultures and civilizations to humanity. And I am speaking today as an international relations scholar. In the 2022 presidential elections, I was known as an ardent supporter of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Just like in 2016, when I supported President Rodrigo Duterte, the primary reason why I supported President Marcos Jr. is his foreign policy. However, I do not support the recent foreign policy maneuver of President Marcos Jr. This is a complete reversal of what he promised during the 2022 presidential one-on-one interview with Boy Abunda on January 25, 2022. Mr. Abunda asked him if he would invite the United States to get involved and help us in our dispute with China. President Marcos Jr. categorically said, no, the problem is between China and us. If the Americans come in, it is bound to fail. Let me repeat that. I didn't invent this. He said this. No, the problem is between China and us. If the Americans come in, it is bound to fail. On February 2, 2023, the Philippines and the United States entered into agreement to expand U.S. access to military bases in our country under the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA, which was concluded in 2014 under President Benigno Aquino Jr. Under Aquino's EDCA, the U.S. military was given access to 5 EDCA facilities. Now, under Marcos Jr., the U.S. military was given access to 4 more. Aquino Marcos, the irony of history. The U.S. State Department said that these 4 that these four more bases, quote, will allow more rapid support for humanitarian and climate-related disasters in the Philippines and respond to other shared challenges, end quote. It sounds very benign. But who are they fooling? The U.S. government-funded Public Broadcasting Service, or PBS, reported on February 2, 2023, that, quote, this move is aimed at confronting China and its focus on Taiwan, which is only a few hundred miles from one of the new locations where U.S. forces will likely operate, and that's in, that is in Cagayan. End quote. A joint report by a former Pentagon correspondent and a diplomatic correspondent wrote in the New York Times, also on February 2, 2023, quote, U.S. officials say they are preparing to surge forces in the event of conflict with China, including over Taiwan. End quote. If you are very observant, you will notice what is kept being repeated and emphasized in Western media. Taiwan, confronting China, conflict with China. And there is a reason for that. Taiwan is in the middle of the defensive perimeter of the United States in the Pacific Theater, which runs from the Kuril Islands to Japan, Philippines, all the way to the Malay Peninsula. I didn't invent this. This is real. Okay? To understand how important Taiwan is in the defensive perimeter of the United States, take a stick and cut the middle. What would happen? The rest would fall. To fully understand current U.S. posturing in our region, one must read the 2022 National Security Strategy of the United States. And they just released this in October 2022. Okay, very new. In part 3, page 23, of the National Security Strategy of the United States, it clearly states that their global priority is to outcompete China and constrain Russia. I think all of us here are old enough, no, to be able to remember the National Security Strategy before of George W. Bush, yung kanyang axis of evil, no? Now this is mirroring it, no? And now outcompete China and constrain Russia. Okay? We already know what we're doing with Russia, no? In page 24 of the section on China, the National Security Strategy of the United States gave an exact number of years. 10. Let me quote it. In the competition with the People's Republic of China, as in other arenas, it is clear that the next 10 years will be the decisive decade. We stand now at the inflection point where the choices we make and the priorities we pursue today will set us on course that determines our competitive position long into the future. End quote. I think that's very self-explanatory. Okay? Taiwan is a U.S. priority. And before I continue this, so anyone who's dreaming that the Philippines is a U.S. priority or the Kalayaan Island Group is a U.S. priority, you will never find it in the National Security Strategy of the United States. Nada. You can find there a sentence about the Philippines, but nothing about extending the MDT to the Kalayaan Island Group. Yes. But you can find a sentence there that the United States is extending its mutual security pact all the way to the Senkaku Island.
Yes, Japan.
So wag na tayong magbobula-bulahan dito, no? Na para ito sa South China Sea and Kalayaan Island Group. Walang ganon.
Actually true.
So Taiwan is a US priority. They have an abiding interest in maintaining peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait, which is critical to regional and global security and prosperity and a matter of international concern and attention. The operative word is critical to regional and global security. Of course, this is just a euphemism to the security of the United States because it is the defensive perimeter of the United States. So what is actually being foreseen by the United States that could happen in the Taiwan Strait within 10 years? So 10 years, ha? Ito. Nakalagay din doon. Changes in the status quo. So what are the changes in the status quo that the United States cannot accept? Either mainland China gains full control of Taiwan or Taiwan becomes independent. So either of these two that the US won't accept. It's in their national security strategy. Okay? So whatever that means, as the United States, okay, or our foreign policy decision makers in this country, no, ask naman difficult questions to those people. Huwag na yung mga pakyut-pakyut. Or better yet, ask President Marcos Jr. He is the chief architect of our foreign policy. Let him interpret this for us. Now let me continue. But let us put this in a larger context. Okay? The national security strategy of the United States. In the discussion going on in the national security community in the United States, okay? Anong nangyayari sa greater national security community ng United States? I will highlight several important ones. Yung iba dito sinabi na ni former Secretary Abella. Okay. In October 2022, the same month that the National Security Strategy was released, U.S. State Department Secretary Antony Blinken declared that China has made a decision to seize Taiwan on a, quote, much faster timeline, end quote. Number two, on February 2, during an event at Georgetown University, okay, just this February 2, CIA Director William Burns said, and I quote, "We know as a matter of intelligence that Xi Jinping has instructed the People's Liberation Army to be ready by 2027 to conduct a successful invasion of Taiwan." End quote. Number three, on January 31, a leaked memo of a U.S. Air Force General Mike Minihan was emailed to airmen under his command, instructing them to prepare for war because, quote, his guts, end quote, tell him they will fight in 2025, end quote. So these estimates are within the 10-year period that is in the national security strategy of the United States. Okay, so they will go to war.
Yes.
The question is when. That's the important question. There's no longer doubt that the United States will go to war against China. The question is when. And now, we have an important study conducted by the Center for Strategic and International Studies, or CSIS, released on January 9, 2023. Diba, sunod-sunod yung mga ano nila, no? Leading to the EDCA.
EDCA.
Okay. So, itong CSIS, you know, this is a bipartisan think tank based on Washington, D.C. Okay? This is not left-leaning. Pero, if you're going to read everything of analysis of what's going on, you know, there is a confluence of right-leaning and left-leaning analysis of what will happen in our region. Okay? So, anong nakalagay dito sa, ano ba itong report ng CSIS? Okay? The report is entitled, The First Battle of the Next War. Oh, di ba? War gaming a Chinese invasion of Taiwan. So, we na war game na nila. Okay? Okay? You know, the military know what war gaming is. Okay? And everyone who studied international relations, you know, knows what war gaming is. I really don't understand. You know, you media, you should know what wargaming is and how important this is. Okay? Baka maiyak na ako dito. Okay. Ito ang nakalagay, sabi ng CSIS sa kanyang release, nung re-release niya itong report noong January 9, 2023. CSIS said, okay, quote, "What was once unthinkable, direct conflict between the United States and China, has now become a commonplace discussion in the national security community, okay, of the United States. Please understand what that means." Okay? Before, people are saying na, no, China and the United States will not go to war over Taiwan. Okay? May mga duda pa, may doubts. Ngayon, wala na yung doubts. Ang question na lang ay when. Okay? And now, the CSIS project designed a war game to model what would be the result of a possible Chinese invasion of Taiwan in 2026. So, pasok pa din to sa 10-year period ng national security strategy ng United States. Ngayon, ang resulta ng kanilang war game model ay ito. If the invasion happens in 2026, they're considering the capabilities of China in 2026. Quote, "China will fail to gain control of Taiwan. The United States and its allies will lose dozens of ships, hundreds of aircraft, and tens of thousands of servicemen. Members, Taiwan will saw its economy devastated. Further, the high losses will damage the U.S. global position for many years. China will lose heavily and might destabilize the Chinese Communist Party rule." End quote. Eh, syempre, hindi naman niya in-advocate na let's not go to war. No? So, ang sabi naman nung report, the CSIS war game model then suggested that, quote, "Victory is not enough. The United States needs to strengthen deterrence immediately." End quote. Okay. To those who don't understand this international relations term, deterrence is to use the threat of force to discourage someone from doing something you don't want them to do. Okay? Maraming iba't ibang uri ng deterrence. I don't want to burden you with a lecture on international relations. You know? And this is often done through a show of force. Okay? In the CSIS war game report, one of the necessary conditions, okay? One of the necessary conditions for China to lose, okay? Is this. There is no Ukraine model for Taiwan. What does it mean? It means that if war breaks out, and if the United States decides to defend Taiwan, U.S. forces must quickly engage in direct combat. Okay? U.S. forces must quickly engage in direct combat. Ano ibig sabihin nito? In other words, U.S. will need to send boots on the ground and not just send arms to Taiwan. So parang Vietnam, no? Ginawa nila sabi, Iraq, Vietnam,
Afghanistan.
Diba? Lahat na may boots on the ground sila. But let me digress a bit. You know, although I am speaking in this forum with the title, Averting a Ukraine Scenario in the Philippines, I don't think that this is appropriate to describe the danger we are facing as a country. It's different from Ukraine. It's an alluring analogy, but it is different. This is far more dangerous.
Yes. Yes. That's
our situation is far more dangerous than Ukraine. Okay? As I mentioned earlier, the key to success of the United States against China is to avert a Ukraine scenario in Taiwan. Which means na kailangan nila mag-engage ng direct combat, no? And not just mag-send lang ng weapons, salapi, at hayaan nila yung mga Taiwanese na makipag-away sa mainland China. Hindi po pwede daw yun. Okay? So I think you now understand why the United States wanted access to four more bases in our country. Okay? And one of them is close to Taiwan. Cagayan. I don't think sa Cagayan lang yan. Diba? Anyone who knows military strategy, look at the coastline in the north.
Yes.
Actually, you can already know kung saan nila pwedeng ilagay dyan yung mga bases. Right. Just look at of how the Japanese attack the Philippines from Formosa. Yeah. Okay? And the direction. They would still probably use that same
route.
Yeah. Hindi lang Cagayan. Huwag tayong magbobulahan dito. Okay? So, let me just further emphasize some important aspects of that war game report. One, the only combatants there are Japan, Taiwan, United States versus China. Wala yung Philippines dun sa war game report nila. Hindi tayo kasali. I-explain ko later kung bakit hindi pa nila tayo sinasali dun. And North Korea doesn't join the conflict. Wala rin North Korea factor. So yung casualties nila dito, it's still a very conservative estimate. No? Can you imagine combatants mo lang Japan, Taiwan, United States versus China? And two, this is the most relevant to us. According to the report, yung kanilang war game doon, the Philippines is neutral.
Neutral pa lang nila.
Hindi. The Philippines is neutral and doesn't allow basing. Access to base in our territory. Do you know what was their basis for this war game report? Whose foreign policy?
Yes.
They based this on Duterte's foreign policy. I didn't invent this.
Yeah.
It is in their report. But they have an alternative scenario in the Philippines. Okay? Sabi nila, pero may alternative scenario. Okay? Ng Philippines, mag-aalaw ng basing sa atin. Okay? Basing in our territory. Especially a site near to Taiwan. So this is what is happening now under the BBM administration.
Yes.
We are now in the alternative scenario of the war game report of CSIS.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah.
So what does this mean to us? Okay? Siyempre, quote na naman ako ng mga Amerikano, no? No? Eh, kasi they're so honest. I can't believe. Naabutan ko lang namang gera, Iraq War, ng major ng Amerika. So, this is the honesty right now is the same honesty that they had during the invasion of Iraq in 2003. Ito, let me quote the answer of Zach Cooper of the American Enterprises Institute. Isa na naman itong think tank based in Washington, D.C. Right-leaning naman to. Okay? Ngayon, nung interview niya, February 2, 2023, with government-funded PBS, the Public Broadcasting System, Zach Cooper was asked, quote, "How will the U.S. use this military bases in the Philippines with the goal of confronting China's influence in the region?" End quote. This is a government-funded channel in the United States. Ganun yung question. Di ba wala nang wala, nakaabog-abog, di ba? Hindi na ito katulad ng mga journalists na nag-ask us doon na pa-sweet.
Diretso na.
May mga pa-humanitarian climate change at chuchu. Ano yan? Saka nakakita ng military deployment for climate change? Tayo ba ang kauna-unang bansang lulubog sa climate change? Hindi. At kailangan ba natin ng help? Is our humanitarian disaster response system during typhoon is in disarray?
That's actually the
question. So Zach Cooper, the one from the American Enterprise Institute, answered, quote, "I think, you know, you need to watch this. Nakakatawa. He was so gentle. Okay? I think the objective here is to provide new assets where the United States can place its forces so they are not so focused on just a few bases in East Asia." Okay? Right now, the United States really uses Okinawa and Guam as its main operating locations. And being able to diversify away from just a couple of locations makes the targeting challenge much more difficult for China. End quote. So kung makikita nyo yung mga release ng mga Western media, meron sila kasing ano nito eh.
Label?
No, infographics. In infographic nila itong war game. Kung ano yung aatakihin ng China. So syempre, yung war game, ang original nilang doon, Japan and United States and Taiwan. So ang nakalagay doon na inaatake, Okinawa and Guam. So remember, how did this guy, American, called us? New assets?
Yeah. New assets.
New assets. Do you know what the United States called us?
Yeah.
When they took us from Spain? Real estate. Natawag sa ating new assets for the United States that will give China a much more difficult, quote, targeting challenge, unquote.
Yeah.
So what does it mean? No, papaliwanag ko. Again, American source, napaka-honest kasi sila eh. Tayo lang yung tarantadong sinungaling. The article of the New York Times is so brutally honest. Quote, "In any war, operational and supply bases would be among the first targets an enemy would try to strike." End quote. Now, Jacob Stokes, a senior fellow in the Indo-Pacific Security Program at the Center for a New American Society and an advisor to Mr. Biden when he was vice president, was quoted in this New York Times article. Okay? He explained that the Philippines will be used as a targeting.
Yes, it is.
Area. Ito ha, itong mismong sinabi niya, quote, "If China is going to try to take steps with its missile arsenal to take out locations where the U.S. projects forces, it now has more targets. It has now more targets it would have to deal with." End quote. This is the article of the New York Times when BBM approve those four more bases. Hindi sa akin to. Sa mga Amerikano to. Hindi rito sa mga makakaliwa. At former advisor ni Biden. Oh, dahil marami na tayo, marami ng target ang China. So crudely speaking, we are another target for China in order to exhaust its missile arsenal. Ano pa bang logical conclusion dun? So, can President Marcos Jr. tell us how many of us will die?
Yeah.
Okay? How our economy would look like after the dust settled? Okay? How are we going to rebuild this republic? Aren't we supposed to be having a public debate whether this is a future we want to have for our country?
Yes. Supposedly. Yeah.
Does President Marcos Jr. have the guts to stand up to the United States of America and say, no, I will not allow the Philippines to be used in your war? Shouldn't the Congress be intervening about this now?
Yes.
Now, let me end by highlighting the following numbers. 2025, 2026, 2027, within 10 years. These are the supposed estimated time frames China would decide to change the status quo by gaining full control of Taiwan. This is according to the United States. These are also the time frames. Remember this. These are also the time frames when the United States could still win against China, though with heavy losses. Okay? Longer than this, the higher the cost.
Yes.
And the less certain is the victory of the United States against China. So, anong ibig sabihin nito? Anong ibig sabihin ng mga numerong ito? Okay? So, what does this remind you? Doesn't this evoke you of the moment when U.S. President George W. Bush tried to convince Americans to gain domestic support for a preventive war against Iraq in 2003? Let me remind you of what George W. Bush Jr. said during that time. Quote, facing clear evidence of peril, we cannot wait for the final proof, the smoking gun, that could come in the form of a mushroom cloud. End quote. Hindi na raw siya maghihintay ng final proof. Invade na. War na against Iraq. And what do you call that? That's what you call a preventive war. And the United States has not abandoned its preventive war doctrine that George W. Bush Jr. instituted. Yes. So the question is the United States already convinced, okay, that it is facing a clear evidence of peril that China will gain full control of Taiwan by military force? Is the United States still waiting for a final proof that China will really do it? May history prove me wrong that U.S. and China will go to war in the time frame U.S. personalities provided. Mamili na lang kayo dyan, 25, 26, 27. Or but within 10 years, ano ba ngayon? 33. Yun ang pinaka-liberal, 33.
Matagal na yun.
Okay? May history prove me wrong that we will be another battleground in a war that is not of our own making. May history prove me wrong that we are once again trapped in the U.S. web of either you are with them or against them. Tinatanong, alam mo yung nagsimula ako nag-post ito, sinasabi sa akin, eh sino pipiliin mo, China or U.S.? Hindi kailangan natin piliin ang U.S. This is American propaganda at work at you. The choice is not between China or the United States, but between being a pawn and being a sovereign
state. Yeah. Absolutely.
In the Spanish-American War, did we have a choice? In the US-Japan War, did we have a choice? Eh, hindi, syempre, colony tayo nun eh. Colony pa ba tayo ng United States para hindi tayo mamili na, oy, kayo na lang magpatayan. You know, heroes are often those who emerge triumphant after a tragedy. But the greater hero is the one who prevented a tragedy from happening in the first place. So, Mr. President, be that hero for our country.
Amazing, thought-provoking, very enlightening analysis and revelations. Thank you, Ms. Sas Rogando Sasot. Thank you very much for your courage and analysis.